Hey, what's going on, guys? I hope you got that Lamborghini you asked for Christmas. Did Santa Claus leave it under the tree? If you didn't, I highly suggest writing him an angry letter and starting a hashtag on Twitter. I'm sure that will get his attention pretty quickly. But for today's video, I wanted to take a moment of your time to talk about hardcore game modes in Call of Duty World War II and how easy it is to get kicked based off of the streaks that you get in the game. It wasn't until late last night I received a lovely email from a subscriber of mine by the name of Luke asking me to do a topic about this. I was planning on doing it anyway, but I had completely forgotten about it, and the update came a couple of weeks ago. But with that said, guys, I hope you all enjoy the video. Sit back and relax. Luke, thank you so much. Let's get going. For those of you that are unaware, at the launch of this game, the hardcore mode was kind of like the Wild West. You could team kill as many times as you want. After the third time, there would be a 20-second respawn penalty. However, people would still team kill over and over again, even with that penalty in place. The biggest reason? All of those deaths, even from teammates, counted towards your kill-death ratio. It was kind of crazy, and trolls had a field day. Obviously, these conditions for hardcore are less than savory, so Sledgehammer went ahead and updated the mode. Taking deaths from accidental teammate kills no longer counted towards your kill death ratio, and there has been a kick penalty added, meaning if you kill three teammates, you will be kicked from the mode you're playing. For a lot of people, this is awesome, because that means people are less likely to team kill now. However, that means if you use big streaks, you're more likely to do it and more likely to get kicked. This is where the rules kind of get fuzzy. If you're using something like the ball turret gunner or the firebomb, the carpet bomb, or even something like paratroopers, there's a big chance that you might get kicked accidentally for team killing, and that's kind of the biggest problem right now. My first thought, what if they were to just completely disable the kick counter for streaks altogether? Meaning if you wanted to use paratroopers and the ball turret gunner and bombing runs and things like that, if you accidentally kill a teammate, then oh well, but at the same time that causes for a lot of really bad experiences for people who are on the field that don't really want to die over and over again. Even though they're not technically taking a death because a teammate killed them, it can still be really annoying if you're engaging in a battle and you end up getting shot from above for something that you literally can't control. I'm sure people would get over it, but at the same time, this also opens up Pandora's box for trolling in general, because someone could run, let's just say, the care package with the Molotov cocktail and constantly rotate through streaks, you know, possibly getting the biggest streaks in the game, and their main goal would be time to kill the teammates. I'm not gonna focus on the enemies, I'm just gonna focus on killing my team. And unfortunately, that is the harsh reality of Call of Duty. People play like that for the sake of trolling, for the sake of trying to get reactions, and I'm sure it wouldn't happen in every single game, but it is a possibility, and I just wanted to look at it from all angles. The conversation can also be directed towards the good old controversial Ricochet. If you've been playing hardcore for as long as I have, you know that when Ricochet was first enabled and first brought into the game, people weren't really liking it all too much because they thought it didn't really feel like a hardcore mode, but it did bring its benefits. The first benefit would be team killing just didn't exist because Ricochet didn't allow it, so that's completely out the window. The other benefit is if you ended up calling in a huge streak, the only person you're able to kill is yourself, and once you're in that streak, you can only do it once, meaning when the streak is gone, you could respawn and be alright. So there's only a maximum of one death you could take if you happen to shoot yourself in some way, shape, or form. But there were downsides as well. Trying to get to that big streak was a bigger struggle, especially if you had teammates that like to run in front of your stream of bullets, causing you to inevitably kill yourself in one hit. And also, the other downside is, it doesn't really feel like hardcore when friendly fire isn't enabled. I know for a lot of people who love playing hardcore and they're adamant about it, it makes it feel like it's just not a fun experience when you can't kill your teammates, which sounds kind of strange, but there are a lot of people that would defend this. I know back in the past, and even in Call of Duty World War II, there were games that I have won because I purposely killed a teammate to try to get a kill on an enemy, which I know sounds kind of crazy, but trust me, it happens from time to time. It's a very rare occasion, but when it does, you kind of feel satisfied when you take out a teammate in order to get the victory. So here's what I think would be a good compromise for the system we currently have with the friendly fire enabled. Anything from the fighter pilot forward streak-wise should not be enabled for team killing. Meaning, if you get a fighter pilot and you fly on in, you see all the red circles and you shoot, and you accidentally kill one or two teammates, that should not count. That should not. Anything past that should not count. ball turret gunner, the paratroopers, all of that stuff that can cause lots of massive damage in hardcore modes, those should all be good to go away from the team killing. But anything under that should count. So if someone wants to constantly throw Molotov cocktails at you just to troll, then they should get kicked after three kills. I like to consider street kills accidental damage, collateral damage, if you will. You don't intend to kill somebody while you're in a ball gunner turret. It's just something that happens when someone gets caught in the crossfire. And then that would make it to where trolls are less likely to do it. People are able to use the bigger streaks. And from there on out, yeah, there's going to be a lot of demolition on the map, if you will. But that's all I really got to say about the hardcore mode. I personally really enjoy it in Call of Duty World War II. I don't think Ricochet would make it any better, but I also don't think it would make it any worse than it is right now. I'm not saying that they should add Ricochet by any means. I personally enjoy it myself, but I know that there are people that share other feelings. But let me know what you guys think in the comments section below. If you guys enjoyed the video here today, take a moment of your time to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And until tomorrow, my friends, I'll see ya. Peace.